Take the shackles off my feet so I can dance. I just wanna praise you. I just wanna praise you.
Shackles on my feet, yeah, they won't let.
Good morning, New Ark Covenant Church. This is the day that the Lord has made, and we shall rejoice no matter what you're going through. We shall rejoice and be glad in it. Amen. God is good. Let us pray. Our most kind and gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, for another day, a day that you have given us to praise and worship you, another day that you have given us to serve you, Lord. I ask right now that you use me, that I serve you in the capacity of awesomeness, of power, of great anointing. I'm asking Holy Spirit to have his way with me, to speak through me to his people. Have your way, Holy Spirit, because we need a word. We are desperate for a word from you. Today, Lord, speak to our hearts, for it's in the Lord Jesus Christ's name I pray. Amen.
Good morning, Newark fam. I miss you so much. I pray that you are all living in God's perfect peace right now. I pray that we approach praise and worship this morning with everything that we have, all that's within us. And with that being said, let's bring our praise.
With presence of the Lord is here. Presence of the Lord is here. I feel it in the atmosphere. Presence of the Lord is here. Oh, presence of the Lord is here. Spirit of the Lord is here. Anybody feel it tonight? Spirit of the Lord is here. I feel it in the atmosphere. The Spirit of the Lord is here. Oh, the Spirit of the Lord is here. The power of the Lord is here. The power of the Lord is here. I feel it in the atmosphere. The power of the Lord is here. The power of the Lord is here. Put your hands together. Make some noise if you feel His presence. Come on, do you feel it? Hallelujah. Let's sing it.
The presence of the Lord is here. Thank you, Jesus. I'm gonna get it. Oh, somebody's getting ready to walk into a miracle. Come on.
If you would, turn to Habakkuk chapter 2, verse 3. Habakkuk chapter 2, verse 3. For the revelation awaits an appointed time. It speaks of the end and will not prove false. Though it linger, wait for it. It will certainly come, and it will not delay. The title of this morning's message is The Good Things to Come. The Good Things to Come. Evil and injustice seem to have the upper hand in our country at this moment, and also in our world today. With the elections coming in 2 days, many people are stressing over the fact, if Trump wins, what is going to happen over the next 4 years? And then you have those who will say, if Biden wins, is there going to be civil unrest? Or is our country going to be a socialist government? Like Habakkuk, Christians often feel angry and discouraged when we see what is going on with our country's government. Civil unrest that is taking place in Nigeria, Venezuela, and the indifferences concerning climate control that is affecting our entire world. And then there is the pandemic and the many other issues we have to deal with, even in our personal lives. We have things that stress us, that oppress us, that frustrate us, make us angry. And Habakkuk complained vigorously to God about the situation that Judah was going through. And God's answer to Habakkuk is the same answer he would give us this morning. Be patient. Be patient. God says, I will work out my plans in my perfect timing. We have to believe that. It isn't easy to be patient. But remember that God hates sin and how sin affects our world even more than we do. Punishment of sin will clearly come, as God told Habakkuk. But he said, wait for it. Be patient. And I know that we're going through a lot of things right now in society. But this morning, Holy Spirit is saying to each and every one of us, be patient. Good things are coming our way. To trust God fully means to trust Him even when we don't understand why events occur as they do. Some people, even some Christians, think that the Bible is not relevant to the current situations we are faced with today, as if God does not see the problems our world is facing at this very moment. God sees everything. He's omnipresent, and He's present right now. And although many think that God is on the throne, not concerned about His people, that is a lie straight from hell. in our message this morning, we will see that the Bible is very and extremely relevant, and God is very present in these trying times. This morning, Holy Spirit will answer the questions we have about our current situation in our country and in our world. The Bible is relevant. It is still the same as yesterday as it is today. Chapter 2 of Habakkuk records God's answer to Habakkuk's questions. But we need to see Habakkuk's question. We will see the answer, but we need to see what his question is. Turn to Habakkuk chapter 1, beginning with verse 2. Habakkuk complaint. How long, Lord, must I call for help, but you do not listen? Or cry out to you, violence, but you do not save? Why do you make me look at injustice? Why do you tolerate wrongdoing? Destruction and violence are before me. There is strife and conflict abounds. The wicked Babylonians trusted in themselves. They thought they were all of that, but in the end, they will fail. They will fall, because wickedness before an awesome, almighty, all-holy God will not stand. God sees what's going on in our country as he saw what was going on in Babylonia. The wicked Babylonians, they trusted in themselves, and God knew that they would not succeed. And in Romans chapter 1, verse 18, we see what God says about sinful people. Turn to Romans chapter 1, verse 18. Romans chapter 1, verse 18. The wrath of God is being revealed from heaven against all the godlessness and wickedness of people who suppress the truth by their wickedness. God sees it, and God's wrath is against sinful people. They have substituted the truth about God with lies. And today in society, people and wicked people and violent people are substituting the truth about God with lies. Romans 1:25 says they exchanged the truth about God, saying that God is okay with this. No, God is not okay with wickedness and lies and deceit. They exchanged the truth about God for a lie and worship and serve created things rather than the Creator, who is forever praised. Amen. People tend to believe lies that reinforce their own selfish personal beliefs. Let me say that again. Are you listening, church? People tend to believe lies that reinforce their own selfish personal beliefs. Today, more than ever, we need to be careful about the things we hear and see on social media, which are very instrumental in distorting the truth and forming our beliefs away from the Most High God. Oh, my. We are looking at things on the internet, Facebook, and all these other social medias, as people on Twitter are tweeting lies, and they expect us to believe it. Let me give you a true example. You will have someone that is living a life that is contrary to the Word of God. And how they'll do it on Instagram or Facebook or on Twitter, they will post a verse, a Bible verse, and they will talk about God. And then they will say some wonderful things about God. But in the next frame, you will see evil. You will see things that are not of God. And they'll be posting these things. Some of them are explicit. And they even begin to say words that they ought not say as believers in the Lord Jesus Christ. They will use obscenity. And then the next verse, they'll have a verse saying that God is good all the time and all the time. God is good. I'm here to tell you, my brothers and sisters, they have exchanged the truth about God for a lie. And the devil is a liar. The devil is a liar. Today, we are constantly bombarded by ideas and beliefs through the many social media outlets and affiliations that are totally opposed to the word of God. My brothers and sisters, be very careful about what you allow to form your opinions. God says, wait, don't get frustrated. You know, sometimes as a believer in the Lord Jesus Christ, we become living sacrifices. And we make sacrifices in this life. We serve God and we try to live the life that is pleasing to God. It's not easy. But it's so frustrating when you see people changing the truth about God for a lie. The Bible is our source of truth. We must evaluate all other opinions in the light of the word of God's teaching. And not be so frustrated, because God says, don't worry about what they're doing, because vengeance is mine. Don't worry about what they're saying about Trump. Don't worry about what they're saying about Biden. Don't worry about what they're saying about these organizations, these domestic terrorist groups. Don't worry about that, because God says, I am in control. Oh, we got to trust them. Habakkuk say, how long, Lord, will you allow these people to prosper with their wickedness? How long? This verse is helpful to all believers who are living in these present difficult times when signs of hope seem so far away. Believers in the Lord Jesus Christ must trust that God is directing all things according to his purpose. Let me tell you something. For those who are not voting for Trump, if he wins, don't worry about a thing. God is in control. Stop being so stressed. Stop being so depressed. Stop worrying. In 2 days, you'll cast your vote if you have not already. But know that God is in control. God already knows who's going to be the next president. God already knows what's going to happen. But he says, but don't worry about evil, because I am in control. Holy Spirit is encouraging us not to abandon our faith in the times of trials and uncertainty, but endure to the end to show how strong our faith really is. If you have faith in God, then trust him and wait on him. Wait on the Lord. Wait on the Lord and he will renew your strength. I wait on the Lord every day of my life. We go through personal things, but we wait on the Lord to come through. And he will come through, because he is a promise keeper. The Lord does not want us giving up. Do not grow weary in well doing, for in due season we will reap a harvest if we don't give up. So don't be worried about tomorrow, for today has enough problems of its own. At times, it may seem like God is taking a long time to reveal his plan. But no matter how long it may take, do not give in, because the Lord will show up on time, because He's an on-time God. He won't come too soon. He won't come late. He's an on-time God. Let's return to our text, beginning with verse 9. Habakkuk chapter 2, verse 9. Woe to him who builds his house by unjust gain, setting his nest on high to escape the clutches of ruin. You have plotted the ruin of many peoples, shaming your own house and forfeiting your life. The stones of the wall will cry out, and the beams of the woodwork will echo it. Woe to him who builds a city with bloodshed and establishes a town by injustice. Has not the Lord Almighty determined that the people's labor is only fuel for the fire, and the nations exalt themselves for nothing? Babylon's riches had come from the misfortune of others, but these riches would only be fuel in the fire, as if it's like fuel in the fire of hell, that those who do not believe in the Lord Jesus Christ and operate in this kind of wickedness will find themselves in. The victims in their cities will cry out against Babylon. Verse 11 tells us that the stones of the wall will cry out. These are the people that Habakkuk is talking about. America is crying out to the Lord. Each and every morning I pray for our country. Every morning when I wake up, I say, Lord, have mercy on our souls. And it's funny how the children of Judah, God's people, had to suffer along with the Babylonians because they had turned to their idols. And I'm telling you today, my brothers and sisters, we must turn away from wickedness. We must turn away from idol worship, because God says, because of what the nation, because of what the world has done, they have turned away from me. They have turned their backs on me, and they are worshiping other gods. Therefore, they will suffer along with those who are wicked in this country. Woe means warning. Beware. That's what woe means. God is warning those who are doing evil in this present time of uncertainty and division. He says it will not go unpunished. It will not go unpunished. But all you have to do is wait. Patience will not disappoint. Patience will not disappoint. The leaders in our world seem to be getting richer off the backs of those who are not rich. But God is taking notice and warning those who are making plans to do such evil. They will be judged. Don't stress it. You say, well, they're going to raise our taxes. Don't stretch it. Stress it. God got us. God got us. Got no money in the bank? No gas in the tank? God's got us. Whoa. Yeah, 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 yeah. God got us. He knows what's going on. And you don't have to worry about your taxes. Oh, you don't have to worry about health care. God got us. Oh, you say, Pastor, let's be for real now. You know, let's face reality. If we lose health care, because I'm a private worker. I've got my own business. And I don't have like that kind of insurance. I can't afford it. What am I going to do? Pray for your country. Pray for your health care. Render unto Caesar's what is Caesar's. God is hearing the cry of his people. God is hearing the cry of his people. Do you believe that? Money is not evil. We need it. But God condemns the love of riches and use of evil means to acquire it. Money is not evil. But God condemns the love of riches and the use of evil means to acquire them. 1 Timothy 6:10 says, For the love of money is a root of all kinds of evil. Many are consumed with the hunger for wealth, so much that they lose their appetite for God. They're concerned about so many other things, but they don't pray. They're concerned about so many other things that they don't read their Bible. They're concerned about what they don't have and what they want, but they don't trust God. You got to be in your word. You got to be on your knees. You got to pray. You can't be so consumed with what's going on in the news. You can't be so consumed with what CNN is saying. You can't be so consumed with Fox is saying. You know, we have the debates. We're so consumed with the facts. What was factual? And we start looking at these things and we're starting to read all these things in social media and it starts to become a little overwhelming. Your answer, my brothers and sisters, is not in CNN. It's not in Fox. It's not what they say in social media. Your answer is right here. And Habakkuk sought the Lord for some answers. Habakkuk sought the Lord for some answers. Are you seeking the Lord for answers? Are you seeking man? Oh, I'm going to get there. The many problems our country is having today stems from the love of money. Unfortunately, the love of money has caused people to allow money to take the place for the concerns of human lives and a love for God. People, you know, the people that's in government, I'm looking at these commercials and you say, well, Pastor, you guilty of it. That's why I'm preaching it. I look at these commercials and you have no other choice because there's so many commercials about what the policies are and who's running this and who's running that and who's going to do this. And they're always talking about each other, calling each other thieves and murderers and being with gangsters and criminals. But the Lord says, be patient, my brothers and sisters. Patience will not disappoint you. Patience will prove to be not false. Turn to Psalms 27. Psalms 27, verse 14. Psalms 27, verse 14. Wait for the Lord. David writes, be strong and take heart and wait for the Lord. Wait for the Lord. Be strong and take heart, meaning to take courage, be bold and wait for the Lord. Oh, stop being so afraid of everything, but be bold and take courage because our God says, I'm coming, but be patient. David knew from experience what it meant to wait for the Lord. And he wasn't disappointed because God always showed up on time. God always delivered him. David, the shepherd boy, had been anointed king at the age of 16, but he did not become king until he was 30 years of age. During the time he was waiting to reign as king, he was chased through the desert by the jealous man named Saul, who was king at the time. David had to wait on God for the fulfillment of his promise to reign. Waiting for God is not easy when going through tough times. It's not easy. We are glued to our televisions, watching the news, the polls, the debates, discussing issues on our jobs, and there's a sense of anxiety. But Holy Spirit is saying this morning, be anxious for nothing, but let your requests be known through what? Prayer and supplication. We claim to be mighty men and women of God, but do we get on our knees and ask God to make a change? Habakkuk say, how long, Lord? Are we getting on our knees each and every morning throughout the day saying, how long, Lord? And listening for his answer? Oh, I know what the Lord is saying. He's telling me I'm in control. I'm in control. Don't worry about a thing. He tells me about worrying. He said, why do you worry when you can't add not one inch to your stature, nor can you add another strand of hair to that bald head of yours? Huh. I said, you're right, Lord. I'm going to wait on you because you are the supplier of everything I need, and you will answer my prayers. You said, I have not because I ask not. And because I'm asking, you said, ask and ye shall receive. And I am receiving the patience and the peace that surpasses all understanding. People say, you're not worried? No, I got peace. Not the peace that the world's trying to give me. Not the peace that Joe Biden's trying to give me. Not the peace that Trump claims to be going to give me, not the peace that any politician, whether it be Senate, Congress, trying to give me. My peace comes from Jesus Christ, my Lord and Savior. That's where my peace comes from. It does not come from anybody else, because even these people, these men, these women, apart from God, they can't do nothing. God knows the urgency of the situation, even if it seems as though God isn't answering our prayers. He knows the urgency. He knows exactly when to step in. God is in control. He's worth waiting for. He's worth waiting for. Turn back to our text. That's Habakkuk chapter 2. That's why you need one of these, so you can turn back there real quickly. Verse 18. Oh, what value is an idol carved by a craftsman? God asking now Habakkuk a question. Or an image that teaches lies? Ooh-hoo-hoo. For the one who makes its trust in his own creation. For the one who makes it trust in his own creation. For the one who makes it, the idol, trust in his own creation. He makes idols that cannot speak. Woe to him, he says in verse 19. Beware. Verse 18 says, or an image that teaches lies, is the question that God presents to his people this morning. Man was made in the image of God. However, because of the fall of man now falls short of God's perfection, of God's glory. In our society, people will put a human before God. Let me say that again. In our society, people will put a human, a person just like them, before God, and will believe the lies of that person. Oh, how long, Lord? How long? Man worship can be a husband, a wife, boss, a friend, a political figure, or a religious leader. God says, woe to man worship. Beware of man worship. And we must not worship any man. I don't care what party you represent, who you're going to vote for. Don't worship that man, but worship the Almighty God. Can I get an amen? We need not put our trust in man, nor make him an idol, because apart from God, what can man do for us? What can man, let me ask you this question. What can man do for you? Answer that. That's the question Holy Spirit is asking this morning. That's the question God was asking Habakkuk many, many years ago. But everything now is so relevant today. Turn to Psalms 11. Psalms 11. Hopefully you heard God answer that question for you. What can man do for you? I'm going to tell you what he can do for you. Not a daggone thing. Verse 4 of Psalms 11. The Lord is in his holy temple. The Lord is on his heavenly throne. He observes everyone on earth. His eyes examine them. The Lord examines the righteous, but the wicked, those who love violence, he hates with a passion. That's Psalms 11, verse 4 through 5. The Lord observes everyone on earth. The Lord observes everyone on earth. They cannot hide. They can't go into their basement. They can't go into their cellar. They can't stay in their house. God sees them wherever they are. Can I preach to you? God's power is not diminished by any type of event, nor the turn of events come Tuesday. Nothing happens without God's knowledge and permission. Do you hear Holy Spirit saying to you this morning? We know things are a mess in our country, but know that God will restore justice and goodness in our country and in our world in his perfect timing. Oh, I'm enjoying this. I don't know about you, but I'm enjoying it. God is not shielding us, though, from our current circumstance with our country and world, but God is testing both the righteous and the wicked during this time. He's saying woe to the wicked, and he's saying woe to the righteous. And he said, those who are righteous better trust me, and those who are wicked must begin to trust me. Hallelujah. Oh, just wait on it. Just keep your eyes on what God is getting ready to do. Oh, people are buying guns and saying that, oh, there's going to probably be a civil unrest. I need a gun. No, trust the Lord. Even if you have a gun, it doesn't mean you're going to be saved, because apart from the Lord Jesus Christ, we can do nothing. He's our shield. He's our buckler. For the believers in Christ, God's test is a refining fire. It only makes us better. While for the unbelievers, God's test becomes an incinerator for destruction. Neither the believers nor the unbelievers can defy God's test and challenges that come our way. The challenges are here not only for the just, but the unjust as well. My brothers and sisters, I'm here to say the just got it made because we trust in God. My brothers and sisters, we as believers in the Lord Jesus Christ must use these opportunities that we are faced with at this present time to grow spiritually, allowing it to build our trust in God and not in a man or a political party. It's time to grow up. It's time to pray. It's time to trust God. It's time to have faith. It's time to have crazy faith. Oh, that's what Holy Spirit told us last Sunday. To endure these times, you have to have crazy faith. You got to believe that the God that we do not see is seen in his ability, in his unchanging hand, and in his miracle-working power. That's how we see God. Man worshipers command their idols to save them. They go on in a booth and they say, you gotta change these things. That's why I'm voting for you. I go and I make my vote. I mail my vote in. But I'm saying, Lord, you know all things. But man worshipers, they command their idols to save them. But we who worship the living God come to him with reverence, with respect. We as believers must acknowledge that God is in control and knows what he is doing. Therefore, if God is in control, what can any politician, governmental, or world leader do for us apart from the control of God? Again, nothing. Can't do nothing for us. You know, it's funny. You know, when Israel didn't have a king, and they saw all these other people with their kings, their leaders, they said, we want a man leader. We want a king. God says, you don't need a king. You got me. I'm your king. No, no, no. We want a king we can see like everybody else. So you know who God gave them? King Saul. And what did he do? Made a mess of things. Made them pay taxes. Made them work hard as like slaves. In the beginning, God says, trust me, I will take care of you. And now he's saying the same thing. You don't need a man king. All you need is me. The living God speaks through his word. And everything God has said this morning is true and powerful, and it will come to pass. He said, wait, I will judge the wicked. Wait, I will correct all of this. Wait, I'm in total control. Habakkuk chapter 3, Habakkuk prays God for answering his questions. Evil will not triumph forever. Evil will not triumph forever. God is in control, and he can completely be trusted to vindicate those who put their trust in him. We only need to be patient and wait for him to act. In closing, Habakkuk chapter 3, verse 16, it reads, I heard, and my heart pounded. My lips quivered at the sound. Decay crept into my bones, and my legs trembled. Yet I will wait patiently for the day of calamity to come on the nation invading us. Our world has been invaded by evil. Our world, not just our country, our world. This morning, the Lord has replied. He said, be patient. Patience will not disappoint. Woe to man worship. Be patient. There are good things to come. Let us pray. Our most kind and gracious Heavenly Father, I thank you, Lord, for the word that you have given us this morning. I thank you in a couple days we will see your plan. And let us not think that you failed us, because you never fail. We trust you. We know that you are totally in control. So we will not fear no evil, for we know that you are with us. We will not worship a man, but we will continue to worship you, Lord, no matter the circumstances, because you are King of kings and Lord of lords. You are the great I am. And therefore, we will rejoice. Therefore, we will know that this joy that you give us is our strength. And this peace that surpasses all understanding is the peace that you give us. Not a man, not a government, not a king, not a president, not anybody in power, but the one that is all powerful and all knowing. To you, Lord, we worship. Lord, I pray your people heard your word and will carry on this morning, not worrying about what man can do, but just trusting you to see the things that you will do and you will not fail. So I thank you, Lord. There may be someone that needs to trust you, but they don't know how to trust you because they have not even yet trusted you with their eternal security to live eternally in heaven with you. If that's you, if you're listening this morning, if that's you, you say, well, I've never even trusted God to save me. I never trusted God to allow me to spend eternity in heaven. Right now is your turn, and you can do it right at this very moment. You can ask the Lord Jesus Christ, who died on the cross for all your sins, to come into your life and save you. Pray this prayer with me if that's you. Say, Heavenly Father, I believe your Son, Jesus Christ, died on the cross for all my sins. And I receive him right at this moment as my personal Savior. For it's in the Lord Jesus Christ's name I pray. Amen. You prayed that prayer. The Lord Jesus Christ came into your heart and saved you. And now you are now a born-again Christian. I pray that God continues to bless you guys. Have a wonderful, wonderful Sunday. And pray for our country and our world. God bless you. I love you all so much.
Shackles on my feet, yeah, they won't let me be. Won't you set me free? Pray this on me. Shackles on my feet, oh, they won't let me be. Won't you set me free? Pray this on me. Pray this all on me.
Let me go. Let me go. I've been going through so much, I swear these people let my throat. That's on me, that's on mamas. On my mama, I can't take no more, so miss me with that drama. Get your commas, get your racks straight. Get your facts straight. Hold me down, I rise up on them like the tax rate. Keep my past straight, never lack faith. God been working, they gon' have to hold me back, man. And tell them, you can pick a side if you wanna. You already know who I bro with. You don't want no problems with me. Get these shackles
on my feet, yeah, they won't let me be. Won't you set me free? Pray this on me. Pray this on me. I got them shackles off my feet, yeah, yeah. Can't put me back up in them streets, yeah, yeah. I couldn't move, but now I'm free, yeah, yeah. I got them shackles off my feet, yeah, 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 yeah.
Down for me, down for me. People left me, you was round for me. Round for me. All that bitterness and anger, had to let it go. People talking down on me, I guess that's how it go. Let them know, that's on me, yeah. Shackles on my feet.